Hello, this is Eric. In general, if you do FaceTime or Zoom meeting, you can see your own screen and the other person's screen as well during a video call. Since this is the most basic part of the video call, I thought about how it could be implemented. So in this video, I'm going to talk about drawing two image sources on one screen. This is being tested with one device. This test first outputs the image obtained from the camera of this device to the screen in the bottom right corner. After that, it sends the image data to the server, and the server returns the data back. The device outputs the data received from the server in the top left corner of the screen. The resolution of the camera is set to QQVJ 160x120. The ST7789 I'm currently using has a 13-inch 240x240 resolution. So if I use a higher resolution, the image size increases and need more time to send it to the server, but there is no benefit. The image quality is important, but latency is also important, so I have tested with this resolution. Since the server is running locally and the size of the image is small, the image is being displayed on the screen without much damage or lag. Next time, I'll test it with a remote server. If possible, I'll prepare to be a more detailed test. First, let's talk about drawing the screen on the ESP32. Since the screen resolution is 240x240 square, it was easy to arrange. Both the outgoing image and the incoming image have a resolution of 160x120, so it was easy to position the two images. The image from the camera is displayed in the bottom right corner, and the image received from the server is up in the top left corner. The code received to the server is handled by one message callback of WebSocket. If the incoming image is of binary type, it's directly drawn as 0,0 coordinates. The reason for using semaphore is to allow two tasks to process tasks one at a time. Here is a Node.js WebSocket server. What we do on this test server is very simple. Instead of sending the incoming image data to all connected clients, it's designed to transfer except for the sender. Again, this is code made for testing, so please don't care about it too much. The server is currently running locally and simply resends the received image back to the other device. The reason we need a server is to make it work even if you and your friends are not on the same network. Usually the reason for making a video call is that you are physically far away from the person you want to talk about. Of course, depending on the situation, it may be necessary even nearby. Anyway, I'm trying to make the server accessible wherever the internet is available. As you can see here, it doesn't seem to be any issues with uploading and downloading images continuously on both devices. Of course, as the functions are added, the code of ES32 and the server will have to be continuously modified and updated. I will continue to update this project. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.